just a brief history. Gayatri is a has a history of nearly 5 decades in the construction business. Started off first in the world's largest masonry dam, Nagarjuna Sagar project in Andhra Pradesh, and then mostly concentrated in the irrigation projects initially. Then I think in the late 70s, when the Vizag steel plant was a large project which was started, a lot of work was done in Vizag steel plant by Gayatri there. Then they diversified slowly into other states. It went into Odisha for the Nalco project, and then Nalco started at the time. Then ventured into UP and West Bengal for NTPC, some projects we had done.
Adding life to your big ambitions, Ultratech, India's number one cement.
I joined the business about 3 decades ago. Then after that, the present corporatized version of Gayatri started by me. Earlier it was more of a partnership company, but the same organization continued. And then after I came, we first concentrated on the Narmada project. We did major canals in Narmada, Sardar Sarovar project we had done. Then the road sector just started. So we were actually one of the first few projects of the World Bank aided projects in Maharashtra. We had done 200 kilometers of highways, which was probably largest highway projects in those days. Then late 90s, then NHI was in the initial stages. We did a lot of projects for NHI. And other heavy constructions like steel plants, power plants were all always cyclical. So roads was the common thing. And then 2006 onwards, we then also ventured into annuity projects and BOT projects in roads. So our focus has always been to best quality and keep the clients happy. But as you say, the construction industry evolved, did existence 4 decades back. Most of the jobs, as you say, highways never existed in India. Highway sector was very small. So irrigation projects were always in all states. So that was the market for heavy construction. Always road projects, the main challenge is land acquisition and client issues. So we finished some successfully, some we are still stuck. Like for example, we did a majority of the Hyderabad Outer Ring Road. That was actually a challenge in sense getting land. But we closely followed up with the government and we were able to get the land being in Hyderabad. So the project was successfully completed. We had 2 annuity projects, 2 EPC projects. We have completed all those projects. Then we have done the EPE project out of one of the package, Eastern Peripheral Expressway in Delhi, which is about completed ahead of schedule. And the recent successful project is the Purvanchal Expressway. Purvanchal, we are doing 2 packages, package 1 and 2, about 80 kilometers. So we are completing both the projects ahead of schedule. So we want to be more of a purely EPC play company. So we have decided also last 5 years that we want to be out of the asset owning business. So we haven't even bid for any HAM projects also. Sectors, roads, irrigation, no water we have entered in. So it's based on, and then we also be looking at urban infrastructure now, like elevated roads, and which is a extension of the same skill set. As you said, roads are always going to be the large part of the market. Construction World magazine is very informative, and some of the new technologies you put and all that, that definitely gives us good insight. And sometimes your annual functions get all the industry guys together. It's a good opportunity for networking between the industry bodies and all that.